Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the 50th show. Oh my gosh, it's gone so fast. Welcome, everybody. So it is a Wednesday night here in the Miss Melly Makes kitchen. It's a cold winter's day, so we're gonna make some warming risotto. It's one of my favorite foods. And not only to make, but to eat as well. Zesty chicken and mushroom, really delicious. And we're gonna try our hand at making some panna cotta. I've only ever made it once, and that was at school in home ec class. So we're gonna try our hand at making a coconut milk panna cotta with rhubarb compote. So it's gonna be tasty, really delicious. First, we're gonna start making a mojito because I found some rum in my pantry. I thought we'd have a bit of fun and some cheeky mint leaves. So what? Two and two equals delish. So before we go into that, we're going to go on our last time on. So for the people that missed it, let's just go back to Monday. All right, so we did a Japanese beef soba noodles, and I have to admit, I love these so much. I made them today again for lunch. So you can see them down below on the screen. Soba noodles is a buckwheat noodle, and then we just made a really simple dressing, soy sauce, peanut oil, some lime juice, some mirin, really, really simple. Just shake it and dress it. And then we served it with some green beans and some steak, which for Exceed, I sliced thinly and fried. But for myself, I would like it medium rare. So I cooked the whole steak and then sliced it thinly. And it was delicious, you can see it. And then we just sprinkled some spring onions or scallions, I think you call them in the US, on top. So very, very delicious. And we also making some bacon and cheese muffins that I've been eating at work the last few days, and they've been delish, warmed up in the microwave. And yeah, it was a really, really good stream on Monday. It was a little bit shorter, but we had so many hosts. We had 5 hosts, bits, a lot of follows, and some donations that helped towards keeping us alive here on Miss Melly Makes. So really appreciated all the love. Thank you guys. So we'll come back here. Hello everyone, how is everyone today? On this Wednesday, it's hump day. We call it hump day. I don't know if you've ever heard of that in the US or in the UK where you are. Exceed, can you pull up the chat for me? Yes, we call it hump day because you're over the hump and it's towards the weekend. So yes, very excited. Scully, thank you so much for the host. Oh my goodness. And I did see Danielle. Thank you, my friend, for that beautiful host. Hello, everyone. Danielle must be on a baby break. Very, very kind of him to host us. And how is everybody? I know you guys play along in his chat, but we wanted to introduce something. Speaking of our good friend Danielle, he introduced us to Danielle Bucks. And it's something that we wanted to implement on our stream. So we have Molly Dilla. It's something that Exceed and I have been working on the last few days, and it's a way of giving back to our followers, to our viewers, everybody that is giving us love. We want to make a really super interactive stream and have a lot of fun with it. And it's not only supporting and thanking the people who are financially supporting us, you know, with bits and donations, but the people that, like yourselves, that are just watching us in chat, you know, having some fun, having some bants in the chat and playing along at home. We just want to have a lot of fun with it. And so if you do !! Molly Dollar, you can, different ways of earning Molly Dollar, and then different ways of redeeming them as well. And we've only put a few things in there, a few redemptions, but we are going to change them over time, and we want your help. How you want to redeem them, different things, fun things that we can do. So we've done a few things. So these are, we thought I'd have a little bit of fun and ways that you guys would find funny. So Warheads are a super, super sour lolly. So once you redeem, you can redeem me eating one of these live on stream. A little bit of funny. And I found this at the store called Toxic Waste. I'm a little bit scared. I'm not a big fan of sour things. And I think the idea in my head was good, but then the actual thought of me eating it was a bit scary. And then, yeah, we'd love to see what you guys think about redemptions and Exceed has just bought me Just Dance on the PC just so I can do it, have a bit of fun, because I've seen so many streamers do it, but I'm not going to make a whole segment of it. I'm not that type of person. But later on in the way, way, way future, it can be a bit of fun that we'll do like a tiny segment on it for redemption. You guys can see me make an ass of myself because I'm the most unco person ever. So we thought that would be a bit of fun. And different things like picking the stream or picking the theme. We had a MasterChef idea of the person choosing an ingredient and then I have to like make two meals or make a whole stream based on one ingredient. Like so that, say if you say asparagus, I have to make three meals. Even a dessert out of asparagus would be a bit funny, but you know, a little bit of challenge for me. Yeah, so yes, let's get into the cooking. I'm going to start with a mojito. So it is a mint lime based cocktail and rum. So I'll get my rum. I found the tiniest, tiny bit of Sailor Jerry spice rum. And I thought we'd have a little bit of fun of it. From tomorrow, the banners will be up. Yes, so we have made everyone zero with the implementation of Molly Dollar. So everybody's on a level playing ground, and then from now on, we can earn and play. It's gonna be good. Mojito is absolutely lovely. Ben, hello, welcome to Miss Molly Makes. All right, so let's go to the prep area. I had to try one out to see if it tasted okay with honey, because I wanted to make you know, a little bit of a healthier version. So I have some mint in there and some lime. We're going to add some more lime. All right, so we're just going to squeeze these in here. Chaos shots. Oh my gosh, I've got a cut on my finger, my thumb. Stop being a sellout and join me party. What's that about? All right, so we've got some mint leaves in there, some lime. Oh. All right. I was on the phone. All right. So we've got some mint and then I'm just gonna pop some honey. This is just my clever little honey. Just like a teaspoon, depending how sweet you like it. So this just sits upside down so that all your honey drizzles to the bottom, because you know how it's so hard to get things from the bottom, so it sits both ways. So if you're running out of honey, you just do it that way and squeeze. Everyone asks me always, like, what is that? It's a weird little instrument. It's not weird. Okay, so then we're just going to mash this all together. Nice and squishy. How is everybody? Hey Moon, how are you? Sorry I haven't read up. Alrighty. So we're gonna put some ice in there. Could be better, Moon. We missed you on our last stream. Okay, guys, I'm just getting some ice. Oh, maybe two's enough. And then some rum. Molly, you should have just... All right. So it's mint. Some spiced rum in there, some honey, lime, chug. Mmm, yum. Yum, yum, yum. Okay. All right, so we're gonna try our hands at panna cotta. Panna cotta is a Italian dessert using gelatin and it's like jelly, like a good creamy version of jelly. Do a shoey, Chaos, no way. No way, never. I discuss, no. not a fan of shoeys. So yes, panna cotta, guys, is an Italian dessert. We are going to make an orange blossom coconut-based, coconut milk-based panna cotta. So not your authentic, traditional panna cotta, but we've got some really cute molds. I have to admit, I did make some previously, like earlier on in the stream, just to make sure that they were okay. But also, they take 3 to 4 hours to set, and I wanted to flip them upside down and show you guys what they look like. So I've got some love heart molds here, and then I've also got some dome half sphere molds in the fridge. They're already nice and cold, so by the end of the stream we can flip them and then decorate them. But I thought that would be cool. So now I halved the recipe, and so I'm going to do another half and do hearts. A little bit of fun, and then we're going to make a rhubarb compote and then put on top. So nice sweetness. So it's going to be delicious, and then we're going to start on our chicken risotto. Okay, so let's get started. Take this away now. Okay. Molly, focus. All right, so guys, this is some coconut cream or coconut milk. You can use either. Just a little bit thicker. It's got more coconut, what is the difference? So it's just thicker, isn't it? Just more coconut solids? Yeah, I think so. Chaos, you don't like rhubarb? I promise it'll taste delicious. We've got some gelatin, rhubarb, some orange juice. You can use fresh squeezed oranges, but this is what I had in my fridge, so this is what we're going to use. Alrighty. Let me find my... My friend's dog's name's Rhubarb. Oh my gosh. Really? To put some gelatin and some orange juice in here. So I'm going to be halving the recipe that I give our subs, just because we don't need a whole load of panna cotta just for Exceedmo. Canoe dog? Canoe? I love rhubarb the dog. Do you love rhubarb the food? So we have the opportunity now, guys, to talk about subs because we're getting our sub button this week. So exciting. So that means we didn't know, but we're getting all three tiers of subs. So that means Exceed and I were just prepping for one. So we are going to be giving all of our recipes, everything that we've made on the show, not just week by week. And all our recipes, we're doing a sub-only Discord channel. So a sub-only Discord channel for chatting, and then also another channel for recipes. And you'll be getting printer-friendly versions of the recipes. So each recipe will be on its own document so that you're easily able to print it, and it will have all the ingredients, all the instructions there. Really, really super friendly. What else? We're going to be giving all three tiers a gift. So for our, I'm not going to tell you, I want it to be a surprise. And after a while, you know, it'll come out on social media or whatever with people posting the photos. But we just want a way of giving you something a little bit extra so that we are going to be sending it out to your house, just so that you have something tangible just to say thank you. It's just a little something. And what else are we doing? We've got emotes. So tier one has one emote, then tier two has the tier one emote and the tier two, and then tier three has all of the three emotes. So we need ideas, what you guys want. The community, the Miss Molly Makes channel is all about you guys. So we want to have a lot of fun with it, and we want you guys to be involved with the process of choosing the emotes. Walking canoe is a sellout. I'm off to bed. Been a crazy night and morning. Stay awesome. Good night, Moon. Thank you. All right. So we have some orange juice here. I'll just tell you guys the ingredients as per the recipe, and I'm making a little bit different. So you're going to be doing 3/4 of a cup of orange juice, 1 tablespoon of gelatin. So let's get our gelatin. And what you're going to do is put it in a small bowl first and leave it for about 4 or 5 minutes so that it's allowing the gelatin to bloom. So it activates the gelatin in the liquid, and then it I don't really know the scientific meaning of bloom, but you'll see, it just activates it. So you just stir it around in your orange juice. There. All right, now we've got our coconut milk, our coconut cream. So what I'm going to do is put that into a Pyrex dish. We're not heating it, we're just going to put it aside. Exceed has moved my Vortex, hello, how are you today? Are you talking to me? I am very good, thank you. How are you? Had a day off, so I had 11 and a half hours sleep last night. So we went to sleep, set my alarm, and then I thought, no way that it was just in case alarm, but I didn't sleep too late. And it woke me up, so I had 11 and a half hours sleep. We got up, we did some walking, we took Romy for a walk. Good morning, amazing Mikey. Welcome to Miss Molly Makes. So we went and took Romeo for a walk, and Steve wasn't too happy because usually it's my job to pick up Romeo's poopy, but then I made him do it today. Romeo's got this thing that he only does his business on one corner. So it's like, as soon as we get there, he smells around and he's like, all right, it's okay to go now. So we call it his special corner. So we took him for a walk, we got home, and we did some stuff organizing the subs, and then I went to the chiro. You know, I've been saying that I've had some issues with my back and neck lately, and so I went to a new chiro in the new area that we've just moved to, and oh my god, he cracked my back like it's never been cracked before. So all my neck, he said, was really, really tight, and so I'm going back next week, just that I, you know, can start looking after myself. I'm on my feet a lot and I'm moving and, you know, having issues sleeping. And I kind of need to put myself first a little bit and work it all out. And then once I'm strengthened and, you know, aligned, then I can do other things. All right, so 2 1/4 cups of coconut milk or coconut cream. So in this gelatin and orange mixture, we're gonna add some honey. So 2 tablespoons of honey. All right. And we're going to heat this mixture now, just slightly to make sure you dissolve all the gelatin and also dissolve the honey. So we're gonna go over to the stove. We're gonna move this guy because he's doing the risotto. The honey comes with us, and we'll get a little spoon. Mikey, is coconut milk like the water from the coconuts? Coconut milk or coconut cream involves the flesh as well. So coconut water is from a young coconut, so an early coconut, whereas coconut milk and coconut cream are from an older coconut that, you know how you see in photos with the coconut, how it's got that white flesh, it's that and it's blended as well. I'm not 100% sure, you can ask Google. Hey Google, what's the difference between coconut water and coconut milk?
On the website Beckagen.com, they say as opposed to coconut water, which is the clear, natural juice you'll find if you crack open a coconut. Coconut milk and creamer made by boiling the coconut meat with water. To read more, look for the link in your Google Home app.
Cool! Make sense? Thanks, Google. Now we both know. Thank you for that question. It's really good. I never really thought to ask. I love drinking coconut water. It's really hydrating. Xie thinks I'm funny, but I really love it. It's really good for you. Okay. So just slightly heated that through. You don't want it too hot.
Alright, and then go back here. And this is your, so your orange juice, your honey and gelatin, and your coconut cream or coconut milk. Add that in there. Okay.
I love how Google knows the answer to everything. I know. Sometimes we can catch her out, the assistant, but she's very, very good. But sometimes it's usually me. I ask the wrong thing. Is there a gaming stream tomorrow? Ooh. What are we making tomorrow? Let me see. So tomorrow we're making Argentinian food. So it's going to be a big stream tomorrow. So we're doing a chimichurri and a grilled steak. We're making empanadas and a creme caramel. If we've got some time, I don't think, not tomorrow, I'm thinking tomorrow's Friday. Oh, no cooking tomorrow, I was talking about Friday. Friday is Argentinian night, oh my goodness. I keep thinking today's Thursday for some reason. I think tomorrow's a non-cooking stream, maybe we'll do some golf with friends. And we'd love to play with our viewers. If you guys have it, let us know if you wanna play golf with friends. We're always keen to play with our friends. I don't think there's anything that Google doesn't know. Maybe. The Google Assistant's a little bit different. Sometimes you can't ask her to set alarms and things like that yet. Well, not in Australia. Well, it's a bit of a secret, but Google Home isn't being released yet in Australia. So we bought one from the US and got it shipped over. Well, for my Christmas present, Xie bought me one. Yes, Xie just said, if you beat Molly, if you beat me at anything, any game we play, then you get Molly dollars. So I'm not very good at anything, but we can play together, guys. All right, so this is orange blossom water. We're gonna add two teaspoons. I'll practice my egg golf then. Yes, Gustav, you have to. It's very, very hard. I didn't realize how hard it would be to play the golf with the egg. All right, so our orange blossom water. You could always use, if you didn't like orange blossom, you can use rose water. What else is there? You could just use vanilla, anything you like. Any other essence. So we're just mixing this and then popping it into our molds. So these are just silicone molds. This is a Wilton brand. There's spheres, any shape you like. All right, so let's just pop this up. The more surface area that you have, the faster that they will cool. And also the more mixture that you put in there, the slower it will cool.
So a way to make it cool faster is to submerge half of it into a, like a cold water bath. What is orange blossom? Mikey, do you want me to ask Google? Hey Google, what is orange blossom?
According to Wikipedia, the orange blossom is the fragrant flower of the citrus sinensis. It is used in perfume making, has been written about as an aphrodisiac, and is the state flower of Florida.
Wow. So orange blossom is the little flowers on the orange tree. And then they get the essence. So it's like getting the oils. If you didn't have orange blossom and you wanted to use it, you can also get an orange. Give me 2 seconds. And for a similar flavor, you can zest an orange. You can always add this just for some extra flavor as well. But what it's doing is adding some of the natural orange oils. Just for a little bit of extra flavor. Khalid, hello. Hello, how are you? And then what I'm gonna do is just scoop this. And then you wanna put it in the fridge for a good 3 to 4 hours. The longer the better. Just until the gelatin firms up, just like jelly. Okay. You find a plate. And just like that. So there's so many different recipes for panna cotta. You can do chocolate, vanilla, caramel. Sorry, salted caramel. So we might do a few recipes. If you guys like it, you can do some chocolate ones or different flavors. You are 10 hours ahead of me. Mikey, where are you living? Where's, you're in the UK? Into our risotto. All right. Very, very simple. She's 7 hours ahead of me. I'm in the UK. Oh, very happy to have you here. Welcome. Alright, so a risotto is a rice-based dish and you're using a short grain rice, like this, similar to what we use for sushi, short grain, high starch content, makes a really creamy, smooth rice when it's cooked. There's different ways that people like to prepare risotto. Some say don't stir, some say do stir, but I'll just show you what I do and how I like to eat it. We're going to make mushroom and chicken. So the chicken's just in the, is just defrosting. So these are portobello brown mushrooms. I like to make it nice and creamy. So this is the blue cheese left over for a few days ago. So really, really delicious. Nice and moldy. If you don't like it, you don't have to use it. You can just substitute with a richer cheese or something like a Parmesan or a Gruyere. We have some Parmesan as well. Or you can just use cheddar. We have some chicken stock, salt reduced chicken stock. I'm off to bed, but I wanted to say hi. 7 hours. You're off to bed already. Good night, Khalid. Hope you have a lovely night. Alright, have some lemon, garlic, onions, and we're going to top it off with some parsley, and then also some dried parsley and some dried oregano leaves, okay? So what we're going to do is start preparing the mushrooms. So what I like to do is cut your onions and your garlic, fry them off. Add your mushrooms,
Usually I cook my chicken, cut my chicken, cook that, take it out, because you don't want to incorporate your chicken at the start, because it's going to be overcooked and really, really tough by the time the food, the full process is, you know, gone through. So I cook my chicken, take it out, put it aside, cover it, and then at the end, reincorporate it, stir it through, and then you've got nice cooked chicken, and really flavorsome, but not overcooked, okay? So the thing that I've learned about mushrooms is you shouldn't wash them. You should just brush off all of the dust with a mushroom brush, if you have a mushroom brush, if you're fancy like that. But you shouldn't wash them because mushrooms are like a sponge and they'll soak up all of the water and you don't want that. Is there a way to peel onions without crying? Mikey, if you keep watching us here, Miss Molly Makes, you learn that I am terrible at cutting onions. So we can learn together a way. I have the thought that maybe I need some goggles, some onion goggles, because I am terrible. Chew gum. Yeah, some people say chew gum. Some people say put a fan in front of you. My thing that I think is just do it quickly. You know, try and chop it and get it in the pan away from your face as quickly as you can. So I am going to be chopping some fine mushrooms and then also some thicker, chunky mushrooms. These ones will cook down and give you a nice color. And then you also got the texture of the chunky mushrooms, okay? You'll see my dog walking around for new viewers. His name is Romeo. He just walks around, wanders. Every now and then, he'll make a few noises. But he just likes to let us know that he's here. Usually if we're cooking some meat, he'll be around, making some noises, asking me for some. All right. I'm going to also be adding some white wine. I think two is enough. Except, can we change the menu, please? Mushrooms are there, and we'll put them on a plate. The dog's like, feed me now, yes. He is, and he gets cheeky, and he goes, like, cries, and makes a good noise at me. He's like, feed me now, or I'll keep continuing to make this noise. So sometimes Ixie has to give him a bone or something, or get him away. Sometimes when people drive past our front of our house, you can see the lights and he barks, so I apologize for that. I do apologize. Okay, onions. So you take one end off, and then you keep this end here intact. Cut it in half. Put your fingers. And then take the skin off. How's everyone been? We had a good morning so far, a good day. So I'm very excited. Once we get this Molly Dollars up and running and you guys start earning, we can create some really fun redemptions. So, you know, fun for everybody. I'll probably make a fool of myself, but that's a lot of fun. I like to laugh at myself. I have a Jack Russell, he's always hungry. When I'm eating, he's always by my feet, yeah. So when we finish streaming, I take the food to the dining table and we take photos of it for our Insta and our Discord. But Romeo will sit at the table and he'll cry. So we just ignore him and he just will ongoing. And then sometimes we know if the food looks really good or smells really good, he'll just like growl. Quite funny because he never really makes noise. He's not a noisy dog.
So what you're doing is running your knife through. And what this bit here, why we kept this bit, you see that? The piece of the onion, is it keeps it all together rather than slipping and sliding. And then you just run your knife through like this. Depending how many you're feeding, depending how many onions you do. This is one of my favorite foods. So when I got my wisdom teeth taken out, I went and stayed with my grandparents and I made myself a big pot of this because I knew my whole mouth would be swollen for about a week. So I made like a big pot and I took it to their house and I literally ate it for a good 3 or 4 days until my mouth wasn't numb anymore and sore. And because you've got no teeth, you don't want to be chewing anything, so it was nice and soft, but it was really delicious. All right, I'll be back in 2 seconds. So we've got our chicken breast there. I'll get that out in a minute. Now we've got our garlic. Oh, my hair's very unruly today. Problems with having curly hair, or wavy hair, it's not really curly. My hair just looks messy all the time. Amazing Mike, thank you so much for the host. You're too kind. I'm so glad to have you here today. Okay. So a way of easy peeling your garlic is just bash it with the back of your blade. So yeah, if you hit the exclamation mark Molly Dollar, it'll show you the way that you can earn the dollars, the Molly Dollar, by hosting, cheering, donations, but also just being in chat and watching along. And then also if you beat me in any games we play, viewer games, then you get some dollars as well. So yeah, we're always keen for ideas for redemptions. And then I'm really excited. I'm really interested if anyone wants to donate, make me cook with one ingredient, like, you know, base one ingredient, that'd be funny. See if I can do it. It'll give me a few days to do some research, but I thought Twitch was all gaming, but now I'm mod for another chef on Twitch. Oh, that's really cool. Another Twitch, who do you mod for? I'm always interested to see other chefs and cooks. And yeah, totally agree. I talked to people in the street, you know, today I went looking for some Star Wars stuff and I was talking to someone. Hello, Demi. Hey Demi, how are you going? I went to talk to someone about some Star Wars stuff for our Saturday stream and we're talking to them about Twitch and they were like, oh yeah, you're a gamer. And I was like, no, like I'm a cook. Like I cook on Twitch. And they're like, that's only for gamers. And I was like, no. There's a whole creative section, and so I like teaching people about the creative whole community, and there's so many cool people doing so many cool things, and that's what I tweeted about today. You know, Twitch is unearthing people's passions and showing them to the world. You know, there's singers, there's dancers, artists, so cool.
Okay, so we've got some garlic there and some onion. So what we're going to do is I'll take this away. Pop it into your heavy base pan. Happy Chef. Oh my gosh, you're the second mod that's come over from Happy Chef. I love him. He's got such a great personality. And he's cooking so amazing. Follow me on Instagram as well. Alright, so we have some garlic in there. And we're going to do some of our onion. We're going to slowly cook that off. Okay. So we're going to go over to the stove. Mikey, are you a chef yourself or you just like watching cooking shows? Demi, how are you today? You still there? Alright, so we're just going to start frying these and make sure they're translucent and they're cooked nicely. We've got our mushrooms. What else do we need to prepare? Oh my goodness, my nose. Okay, while we've got a nice clean knife, what we'll do is prepare this cheese. Nice blue cheese. Put that to the side. So as I said, if you don't like blue cheese, you can sub it out for anything you do like. Oh. I love watching cooking. Can't cook myself though. I'm learning. I just stream games. Oh, very cool. I'll have to come check you out sometime. We love supporting other streamers. So, if you are a streamer, please do let us know. Small streamers, bigger streamers. I know I'm a big believer of supporting each other. A lot of love, you know. Blocks of my own stock that I've made in the freezer, and I just haven't got around to breaking them up into usable pieces. So they're in like huge chunks, and I made the mistake of, I was being lazy, and I will admit my laziness. I usually like to do them in ice cubes or something like that, or a smaller container so you can just break it with a hammer kind of thing, like a cooking hammer. But I was lazy and I put them in a big container. Coffins, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to Miss Molly Makes. Nice, so nice to have you here. And if you feel comfortable, please tell us where you're watching us from. We love new people. We'd love to know where everyone's coming from. So I was being lazy and I put the stock in the wrong container and now it's really hard to use. All right. Let's go to the stove. What I'm going to do is get my ladle, my cute little ladle, Loch Ness Monster, and I'm just going to add a bit of stock. And we're going to be using the Boreo rice, risotto rice, it's called a Boreo rice. When Twitch first started, it was just games. Now there's music streams and cooking plus. I know, it's so amazing. I was doing it this morning actually. searching through all the communities and checking out some streamers. All right, and then we're just going to add the mushrooms. And we're just doing the Crash Fam, which we're very, very lucky to be a part of. And there's singers, there's gamers, of course, a few creative streamers, so myself, there's Chef John Reed, who cook, then there's singers, people that are part of bands and live stream them, their live music, there's artists. It's so, so cool what, you know, is available, you know, and the use of technology as well. And we have a new thing that we're going to start doing is some Twitch streamer shout outs. So when our subs come along in the next week, we'll give you some more information about the shout outs. So just slowly cooking down these mushrooms, and then they're going to release their nice brown color. The mushroom risotto isn't the prettiest looking dish because of the murky kind of color, but it tastes so good. It's just like there's some things that don't look good, but taste amazing, and there's things that look good but don't taste so good either. And then I'm going to add some wine. So this is just a Sauvignon Blanc. Sauvignon Sauvignon Blanc. I'm looking forward to playing the Crash Bandicoot remake when it comes out on Friday. It's only on PlayStation, isn't it? Is it PlayStation that it comes out on? Alright, so half a cup of white wine. Sorry, 2 cups. Who's this pro? Hello, how are you? So a bit more wine. Drunk. Getting drunk. Risotto, yeah! PS4. Yes, I remember. It was the console that we don't have. Exceed and I just have Xbox. We did initially buy Just Dance for the Xbox. But I had to return it today because I thought if we do it for a redemption with the Molly Dollar, then we'll have to buy a capture card and things like that. So we really don't play many games on the Xbox anymore. And now that I have my own PC. Crash Bandicoot game, but with better graphics. Crash Bandicoot was one of my fave games as a kid. And I used to play it at my cousin's house. And where were we? I took Exceed to a video game museum a few months ago, and they had old school consoles, old games that had been old consoles that had kind of been fixed up. So we played some Crash Bandicoot, we did Duck Hunt, things that, you know, from our childhood was a bit of fun. There's a bit too much liquid in here, but what you're going to do is cook your garlic and your onion, add your mushrooms in, add a little bit of liquid, then add your rice. Cook the rice in there for a few minutes just until it starts to kind of fry a little bit, and then slowly, scoop by scoop, add in your stock. You
going to put some pepper in there.
So I like to put my pepper in and then my salt at the end, because you're going to be adding cheeses, the lemon zest and the lemon lemon juice. So I like to season the salt last, just so that you can balance it, because some cheeses can be saltier than others, especially with the blue cheese. You don't want it to overpower and be too salty. Alright, so just some pepper. These are my automatic grinders. Everyone freaks out and asks what they are all the time. And I'm a big pepper fan, so you don't have to add as much as I do. So as it absorbs, you then you want to add some more liquid. Alright, and now we're here, what we'll do... Keep my eye. Just gonna put that over there. Put this blue cheese over here, and now we'll start preparing the chicken. So we're going to, in another fry pan, prepare the chicken. So you can poach your chicken, bake it, it's up to you. I'm just gonna quickly fry some, and then add it in at the end to the risotto, okay? I always cook this cut left-handed on the stream, I don't know why. I like to do nice strips of chicken. Run over here. We're going to add some more liquid. Hey Molly, hey Squirrely, how are you? Alright. And so you're adding enough liquid until the risotto rice is cooked. So you may need more stock. You may not, just keep an eye on it. Okay. So then I just prepare my chicken, just cutting it into strips. Wednesday already. The weeks go so fast. And we're already at our 50th episode of Miss Molly Makes. So we've only been streaming for just over 2 months. It's very, very exciting. I feel like we've accomplished so much already. We've got so many things ahead. Getting our sub button has just been announced by Twitch. I love that we get news when we wake up. So the time zone, it's released in the US, but we get it when we wake up every morning. So they announced that in the next few days, we're getting our sub button. And they didn't really, when they announced this affiliate program, they didn't give us too much information. So we were just thinking we'd get a $4.99 sub, sub badges and one emote. But turns out we're getting the $4.99, $9.99 and $24.99 subs. And we're getting an emote for each tier. So keep your eyes on our panels down below, because in the next few days when it's all announced and we get the button, we'll be announcing what we're going to be doing for our subs. We have said that we are going to be giving all our recipes away, but we also have extra special things to give away to you guys. For the people that choose to support us, not only watching and cheering and things like that, but also just with your time, we like to say thank you and give our appreciation. So there's a few extra special things coming to our subs. And also with Twitch Prime announced in Australia, you can use your Twitch Prime account to sub to Miss Molly Makes. And at the moment, it's at a discounted price, so it works out to be 40% off your sub. And that includes, not only if you sub to us through the normal sub button, you get no ads on my account, on the Miss Molly Makes channel, but with your Twitch Prime, you get no ads anywhere, which I signed up purely because I hate ads. But supporting other streamers has been really great. Okay. So in here, we have our garlic, our onion, our mushrooms, arborio rice, we've got some white wine and our stock. And then we're going to add some dried parsley, dried oregano. You can also have some dried basil if you like. So, half a It smells so good already. Super, hello! How are you? Alrighty. So the reason we're going to fry our chicken rather than just adding it in at the end is when you're frying it, you're adding some caramelization and brown to the edges. So what we're doing is adding extra flavor rather than just poaching the chicken in and heating it up in the risotto rice. And we're also making sure by frying it, then adding it at the end, we're not overcooking the chicken. We're controlled. Half cooked it, so me. I ordered a wood whistle from Amazon, but when it came, it wouldn't whistle, ha ha ha. I was like, what is it going on about here? Good one, Super. Right. So it's cooking slowly. I'm gonna turn this middle one on here. So Super and the people that just joined us, we were just chatting before about our Molly Dollar. It's our new currency that we have on our stream What was I saying? Did that just glitch? Yes, Molly Dollars. So you have to tap in Molly Dollar. It's our new currency where we are giving back to you guys who are supporting us. You guys are accumulating points and accruing points by everything that you do on the stream, watching, following, hosting, everything like that, the interactions that you have with our stream, and then you can, over time, once you accrue them, there's different things that you can redeem them for. So little things from me eating really sour lollies, which I'm very scared about, to doing stupid dancing, and we'd love to hear what you guys want. Ideas for the redemptions as well. We have ideas where I cook a specific meal with a specific ingredient. But they're only our ideas up there at the moment. We'd love to see what you guys think. So we're just gonna add some oil. Molly Dollar. Okay, now I'm gonna add the chicken. As interactive stream as possible, redeem a 3D print of a trophy for Burnstead. But there's ways when we play our
games with viewers, like a golf with friends and Overwatch and things like that. If you beat me, which is most likely, let's be honest, whoever beats me gets points as well. And you can redeem them and you can choose the theme. You can make me do a dress up on stream or things like that. Just a bit of fun. And we're also keen for you guys to give us ideas for emotes. So we need some ideas. And then starting from tomorrow's stream, we'll have the banners back on up here on the green screen. So you guys can see who's leading. Three different things. A bit of fun. And then it will always hopefully be changing because, you know, we catch people at different times and their schedules when they're viewing. So it'll be a little fun. Return the wolf. Guys, I return the whistle and try to steel whistle. A steel wooden whistle. So yes, tomorrow is a non-cooking day, non-streaming day, but we may play some games with our viewers. So if you guys are around, we may play some golf with friends. Just changed to, we've got no night spot anymore. You guys notice? All right, get my other skipping board. And then we're also, our panna cotta that we started is in the fridge. We're also gonna top it with a nice rhubarb compote. So like a softened rhubarb, nice puree. Not puree, sorry. A compote, so softened rhubarb, and then nice sweetness. Add sweetness to the coconut. If you didn't like rhubarb, you could use something like pineapple. Is really good flavor that works with coconut. You can do mango, any tropical fruit. Nimra? Is that how you say it? Nimra? Welcome to Miss Molly Makes. Thank you for the follow. So lovely to have you here. Oh my goodness. Nimra. We love to know where our new followers are coming to us from. So if you feel comfortable, hit us up in chat and tell us where you are. Adding a little bit of caramelization, a little bit of brown. All right. Slovenia, oh my goodness, welcome. Hey, 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 hey.
Where are the band of Usual Suspects? I don't know. Maybe Hump Day. Hump Day's a little bit of a different day for everybody. We don't get some of the usual guys, but we like to have, we have new people here. It's very exciting. Thank you for the bits. Love it. Super. So I'm a little bit sore. Nimra, what are we cooking? We are making risotto, so a mushroom and chicken risotto. And then we have some panna cotta that we've made earlier, and that's in the fridge cooling up. And we're going to prepare a nice rhubarb compote or a rhubarb sauce to go on top. As I was saying, I've just been to the chiropractor today, so I'm a little bit sore all over. C-Brown stopped in before, not sure if she's still watching, yeah. Moon was here, but he's gone to bed. All right. Nice. I like all, now I'm hungry. Good. We love to make people hungry here. And tonight is our 50th episode. Where has the time gone? Oh my goodness, it's gone so fast. So fast. So I've been preparing today for our episode on Saturday, our episode of Gamer Grub. We had a vote on it during the week last week, and Gamer Grub, for those who are new, is our episode where we do themed food as pop culture, games, movies. So we voted, and the audience voted for Star Wars. So there was Star Trek, Star Wars, Guardians of the Galaxy, and Minions, and everybody voted for Star Wars. So we have a surprise guest coming in on Saturday, and then we're also going to be making some Star Wars themed treats. So I've been preparing that today. I've got some things organized and got my recipes all done. So I'm very, very excited. I'm gonna put some effort into it and theme the kitchen. It's gonna be a lot of fun. And Friday night is going to be Miss Molly Makes Around the World, our show where we do themed cuisine. And Super, our friend, our beautiful viewer, has given us the idea for Argentinian food. So next time, what we're doing is some chimichurri. So a really nice sauce. We're doing some grilled steak, empanadas, and some creme caramel. Hi, Beast. Oh my God, it's frozen. Look, Will's so excited. You broke it. No, welcome to the show. Welcome to Miss Molly Makes. Thank you for the follow, my friend. I love that name, Hype Beast. Yay, Argentinian food. So I used to live in Brazil, and the food's quite similar, but Argentinian meat is on point. So we're doing a skirt steak, as you call it in the US, but it's this really nice cut of meat with a beautiful rich herby sauce. And then we're also going to make some empanadas, so some meat, different meats wrapped in some dough and then baked. And then we're also going to be making some creme caramel, which is delicious. You lived in Brazil. I did, Super. I went on exchange when I was 17. And I went to a country where I knew nobody, didn't know the language. And it was probably one of the best experiences of my life. I learned Portuguese. I met so many beautiful people. It was amazing. So we're going back next year. My brother's getting married in Colombia, because he's dating a beautiful Colombian girl. Brave 17-year-old Lauren, yes. It's very, very scary, but it was the most amazing experience. You know, traveling by yourself. I'm the biggest advocate for traveling by yourself, getting out of your comfort zone. Not even traveling, just maybe going to the movies, walking down the street, you know, being in an unknown area, out of your comfort zone, teaches you so much about yourself and makes you grow. So yeah, it was one of the best experiences of my life. And yeah, my brother's getting married in Colombia, so when we go to Colombia, we have to stop by Brazil. It's gonna be amazing. Take my my family back to see my host families. It's gonna be good.
I always break stuff.
Hype Beast, so cool of you to have you here. I can't even speak English. So good of you to have you here. No, that's still not right. Oh my gosh. Oh. So nice to have you here. That's what I was supposed to say. Hype Beast. If you want to let us know where you're from, that would be really cool. Could 17-year-olds enjoy cachaça in Brazil? Super, you have to be 16 to get into a nightclub. And 18 to purchase alcohol, but yes, a lot of the 16-year-olds were drinking alcohol and getting quite intoxicated. So yes, my host dad did make me. I turned 18 over there, so I was legal. But he made me the best coping I've ever had, and also made me sakinha, use like a caipirinha, but using cachaça and sake. So it was very, very delicious. Do you like Harry Potter? Nimra, we did a Harry Potter theme on the weekend because it was celebrating 20 years of Harry Potter, and we had a lot of fun with it. We did some voting on who was the best house, and unfortunately, everyone voted against me, and they said Slytherin was the best house. I was voting for Hufflepuff because I think Hufflepuff is so fun to say. You're from the USA. Hi, Beast. Good morning to you then. All right. We're going to taste, and then we'll probably add some cheeses. Mmm. We love welcoming our new followers and our new viewers, Hype Beast. So it's very nice to have you here. Are you on the West Coast or the East Coast? Drinking my mojito I made earlier. All right, so this is the blue cheese, and then I have the parmesan running around somewhere. And we're going to, let's go here, top it off with some parsley. So this is for later on when it's all cooked and all prepared. Bit of colour going in there. Nimra, what are you saying yeah to? That I like Harry Potter? Omit that and add two different types of cheeses. So we're gonna go back here, turn the heat off, add our blue cheese, break it up. It's gonna melt with all the heat. Going to add in our even more creamy, add some sour cream or some purple cream. There we go. I'm just going to add that chicken back in. So this is the cooked chicken that we made before. We just pan fried it and see it's got nice juices. So we're just going to incorporate that. I incorporate it at the end so that it does the final bit of cooking and adds all a little bit extra flavor, but then you're not cooking it with all of the rice and the onions and things like that, because you're going to end up with a really overcooked piece of chicken and it's going to be chewy and unpleasant in your mouth. So not a nice thing that we want to do. All right, toss in some of that parsley. And then I'm going to get, here it is, our microplane that we used before with the panna cotta. I'm just going to put a little bit of lemon zest. This adds a little bit of bazing, a little bit of something. Romeo, don't call me. Bottom. A little bit of orange zest in there, but it doesn't matter. Oh my goodness. Yum. What is panna cotta anyway? Super. Panna cotta is an Italian dessert. Hey Google, what's a panna cotta?
Panna cotta, a cold Italian dessert made with double cream, often served with caramel syrup.
Yeah. So it's an Italian cold dessert. We have prepared a non-traditional version. So we've used coconut milk rather than the traditional cream, like thickened double cream version. So you want it's using gelatin. So what I think of it is similar to like a jelly, a creamy version of a jelly. So you use the traditional version has cream, gelatin, and some flavoring. And then you put like a syrup or a topping over top. We've used coconut milk, gelatin, some orange juice, and then some honey to sweeten. And then we're going to make a rhubarb compote or like a rhubarb sauce to sit on top and add some nice sweetness and some beautiful zestiness. All right. So let's bring this deliciousness over. We've got a plate. How do you ask Google? I have a Google Home. So, hey Google, stop. Okay, so I have a Google Home behind me, or behind the camera, and we just ask it questions. I can add things to my shopping list, and it's probably the best thing ever. All right. Beautiful mushroom risotto. It sounds very posh. It is very delicious. The first time I had proper panna cotta, I made some at school when I did cooking classes at school. But I sat, when I was traveling by myself, I traveled through Europe. So I sat in Florence outside one of the cathedrals at a cafe, and I drank iced tea, Italian iced tea, and also a panna cotta. And I sat there by myself just watching the people walk past for a good hour or so. I'd been shopping and I bought some Italian boots, an Italian bag, our group had gone off and I was kind of lost, but I didn't want to worry. So I sat down and then, I ate panna cotta underneath this, beautiful view of a cathedral. It was amazing. Okay, so bun. Slovene Potica. The second Greece.
gone. It's still here. Ready? Oh, this way. It's still there. We have a strip of potatoes, so we've started a new thing. What we introduced the other day, but we've now finalized it. What we're going to be doing is Molly Dollars. So it's a currency that we have on the stream, and you can earn Molly Dollars by hosting, following, cheering, donating, but most importantly, just being here in chat and just being watching the stream, you can earn money, earn the Molly Dollars. And then there's also really cool things that you can redeem them on, things like making me eat sour lollies. So we have some warheads, we'll go here, some warheads, this extremely sour lollies. So we thought that'd be a little bit of fun for you guys. So this is toxic waste. This is a bit scary. I thought that it was a good idea, that you guys would find it funny, me like screwing my face up and dying in on screen. But actually, like in reality, now it's here, I'm a little bit scared. Toxic waste are horrible. Ooh, don't tell me that. So there's things like double or nothing. So you guys can go in double or nothing and bid money, bid the dollars. And I can do things like flipping a pancake or flipping an item. And if I flip it correctly, then you guys get nothing. But then if it falls on the floor or I screw up, then you guys double your points. So a little bit of fun. We wanted to make it interactive as possible and have a really fun stream, but then also give back to you guys who give so generously to us. So that's what it's about. You know, this stream is fun for us, but we want it to be fun for you guys and give back. Okay, let me stop talking. Oh my goodness, I can ramble all day. So we're going to put our risotto on here. Oh my goodness, it smells. I lick my finger and it tastes amazing too. Yeah, so we're always looking for ideas of redemptions. There's something you guys want to do, or there's something you guys don't really like on there. You can always change it up and have some fun with it. That risotto looks amazing. Not that I've just. Nom, 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 nom. I like my my risotto a little bit waterier, saucy, you'd say. I really wish you could send that to us. Seed risotto before, and it was probably one of my go-to things. My brother would laugh, who Belgor, the chef, would always laugh at me because I'd always, if there was risotto on the menu, it was always the thing that I got. It was always the thing I ordered, and I'd always make this same recipe. It was my favorite risotto to make. So you've got some chicken and mushroom risotto with what did we use? We used garlic, onion, we fried them in the pan, we added our mushrooms, we added some white wine, some chicken stock, our arborio rice or our risotto rice. Then we've fried some chicken in another pan, and then we've added that at the end. We've put some blue cheese, some parmesan cheese in there as well. We added some oregano and some dried parsley, and then we've topped it off with some fresh parsley and the parmesan cheese as well. Maybe we put a little bit on top. That's amazing. Let me take this one off. Sea brown. Yes, so we made sure
from the introduction of Molly Dollars, we made sure everyone was zero. We didn't want to retro-date it. So everyone started on zero, and then you accrue points from today. So there's different ways you can check on the Stream Elements website how you can accrue points, and how, also how you can redeem them. Okay? So... can't really... Yum! So these are the ones that we made on stream. See how they're still a little bit wet, watery, and not as cooled enough. I did make some this afternoon in a different mold so that you guys can see what they look like. And we're going to prepare the rhubarb compote. So see if you can put up the other. I think we need to eat some of this first.
Just because it looks so good.
Have some of this. Can you guys see? Oh my god. Did I miss the whole stream? Almost finished, not finished yet. So see, Bran, you said it's your 10th, but you probably, everyone's really even, I think, unlike you. So good. Okay, let's get this started. So we're doing our rhubarb sauce. Check out the lid board.
Yeah.
So get another knife. So these are just rhubarb stalks. And I'm just going to cut them. So rhubarb is delicious, but the leaves are poisonous. So when you buy them at the shop, the leaves are cut off already because you don't want anyone to eat them. Okay, so I'm just gonna do, how many? 2 inches? 2 inches? Pieces? And then we have our small saucepan here. Pop that in there. What a dangerous vegetable. Yummy, feed me. It is so delicious. I'm so excited. I have been eating some. A bit naughty, but. A good chef always tries their food.
That's my excuse anyway.
Alright. To this, we're going to add some honey. Honey makes you funny. Where have I put my honey? Molly, where'd you put your honey? Oh, it's over the side. Okay. So we have 2 tablespoons of honey. 2 tablespoons of orange juice. I might put a little bit more. Is that rhubarb? It is. So rhubarb is, I think it looks like celery, but it's a red version and you slowly cook it and it makes the most beautiful sauce. This is just the orange blossom. And then I'm gonna add there we go. I'm gonna go to this fry pan. Turn it on and cook that. Okay. scariest thing is going to be taking these panna cotta out of their mold. So I'm a little bit worried. Hopefully it works. Let's cross our fingers when we get to it. Oh my God, guys, this is so good. Amazing, Mikey. Rhubarb goes well in a pie with apple. Yeah. You probably didn't catch our episode. So on Friday, last Friday, we did an episode of Miss Molly Makes Around the World, where we do our themed cuisine. And we made food from Chicago, Illinois. And we were told by one of our other streamer friends that Chicago at the moment is having a rhubarb festival because rhubarbs are very ripe in Chicago at the moment. So we made some apple and rhubarb tart. Oh, so good. Very yummy. Childhood treat as well. We used to have apple and rhubarb. Like a lot of people. Dishes. Xeed's gonna be happy. Hype beast, I wish I could cook. Well, if you stay around here more, then we can teach you a few things. Any questions you have, feel free to ask. And if I don't know, then we can find out together. Everyone can cook, it's just some people's need to be taught. Yes. But the more you cook, and what I love to do is people have this fear of getting in the kitchen, fear of trying new things and cooking because they feel they're gonna fail, right? It's like with everything when you're trying a new task. But the more you do it, the more you play around with cooking, use recipes, and if you're worried, follow the recipe to a T until you feel comfortable to extrapolate and try new things. And then the more confident you'll be and the more you'll be able to try new things. So start with some simple recipes. A lot of our recipes that we have are very, very simple and are straightforward with the instructions and the directions, and you go from there. After a while, when you've been cooking, like I've been cooking, kind of don't really use recipes, which is sometimes a good thing, sometimes it doesn't work out. All right, so these are our panna cotta, and these are half dome molds. So we're gonna try, cross our fingers. Put this one away. Hey, Robin. Oh, I should have cut these rhubarb in half, but it doesn't matter. I have a question. Why do Australians call us British pommies? Hey Google, why are British called poms?
Sorry, I don't know how to help with that yet.
She doesn't know that. Google. Were you that guy from last night? Your potatoes. Can you Google that for find out? I want to give them the right answer. I think, isn't it a derogatory term? Prisoner of Her Majesty, yes. Okay, let's do this. Okay, so what I'm going to do is use the mold and make sure that, see how it's lifting away from the edges? You wanna make sure that you've separated it. So find a bit that is, and then roll it around so then it will kind of lift itself off. Oh my gosh, I'm so nervous. I'm so nervous. Okay, so what I'm gonna try and do is take this out of the tray. So I put it in a tray so that it was stable and a flat surface. Okay, let's do this. All right, guys, hold your breath. Oh my God, I'm so nervous. Oh, I don't know how to do this properly.
It's hard because it's so close together. It's not like one, you can flip it upside down. What if I do it with my, no. How am I gonna do this? Because I don't want that sword to come out. Okay. I don't want these other two to come out. How it's, you do this and it pulls away. You want to make sure it's doing that all the way around. See how that's breaking off? You don't want that. So. You can always put your finger. And the longer you keep them in the fridge, the harder they will be. The gelatin will set. And you want to make sure you have the you want to have the right ratio of gelatin. Jelly, it is. It's very similar to jelly. I'm so happy. So this is our rhubarb jelly, rhubarb compote. What I'm doing is I forgot to cut the rhubarb lengthways in half, so I'm just gonna get a knife and run it through and cut them in half. Just a bit too chunky. Come on. Maybe I'll use a fork instead. You guys see what I'm doing? So I just need the rhubarb in a bit of a smaller piece. I should have done it earlier. Naughty Molly. Molly wasn't focusing. Ask the same question about the pommies. Does that mean you already know? I'm just checking if we know. Strip for potatoes. Amazing that I'm no prisoner. That's good. Dr. Phil, hello. Welcome to Miss Molly Makes. Love the name, my friend. Alright, so that is our rhubarb. I'm just gonna cook it a little tiny bit more. Just so it softens a tiny bit more. I'm gonna add a little bit more of the orange juice. I took a little bit out, but it needs a little bit more. Something, something. So, for our new viewers that have just joined us, we've made a panna cotta, not a traditional panna cotta. Can you cook some Swedish meatballs, Dr. Phil? If you check out our past episodes on YouTube, we did make Swedish meatballs a few weeks ago for an episode of Miss Molly Makes Around the World, our show where we do different cuisines. So we made a whole show full of food from Sweden. So it was delicious. We made Swedish meatballs, we made some semla, and also we made some crisp bread. Do you like it? Oh, they were so good. Exceed, what do you think of the Swedish meatballs? He was a big fan.
this is our panna cotta. So we did a non-traditional panna cotta with a coconut milk base. So vegan base, if you guys care about using coconut milk. So non-dairy, a little bit of something different. And then we're going to put a orange blossom and rhubarb compote on top. So ideally you want the compote cold because it's going to melt this, but I didn't really have time, so I should have done it at the start. One of the most filling meatballs of my life, yes. Come to Sweden and try the food festival. Is there a food festival, Dr. Phil? And then we made our risotto and also made a cheeky mojito. America has the most basic food. No, I totally disagree. Thank you, Danielle. Thank you, welcome back. And thank you so much for the host before. I really appreciate it. So good of you to have you here. So good to have you here. Blah, 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 blah. Molly can't speak. Danielle, because you're here, I should tell you that you were the inspiration for our new Molly Monies, Molly Dollars, they're called. So we are starting as of today, we have Molly Money. It's called Molly Dollars, I keep getting confused. It's called Molly Dollars. So you can exclamation mark Molly Dollars in the chat, and then you pop up the screen. You can see how you can earn Molly Dollars and then also how you can redeem them. Yeah, a big festival of food all around the world. Wow, Dr. Phil, that's exciting. All right, so guys, we've made our chicken and mushroom risotto. Looks so good, tastes so good. And this is just our panna cotta. So it's like Italian jelly. So we use coconut milk and then this is our rhubarb compote that we should have made some before, so it was a little bit colder, but what we can do, okay. Oh yes, Danielle, push up king. So we redeemed some of our Danielle bucks in Danielle's stream. For those that don't know, Danielle is an amazing streamer. He does NBA streams and is the most chilled out guy. The loveliest, you know, has the warmest heart. So we redeemed some of our Danielle bucks, and last week he did Zumba, and then today he sent us a video of him doing push-ups. So we took that inspiration and we love to have some fun with it because we love seeing Danielle and, you know, doing things for chat and, you know, his interaction. And such a great stream to be a part of. We love popping in there. So yes, thank you for that, Danielle. Not sure, but I don't think the link is going to your store. Okay, thank you, Danielle. I appreciate that. Okay, so we've got our rhubarb here, our cooked rhubarb. Oh, it's too hot. It's slipping off. Ha! It's too hot. Molly. Doesn't look too good, does it? I'll post a photo on Twitch and Twitter, on all our socials, and you guys can see what it's supposed to look like. Oh my gosh, Molly. So you're supposed to cool down your compote. There we go. It's like Italian jelly. So it's just gonna slide off. Molly fails, that's what we're gonna call it. But it does taste amazing. Eat a warhead sounds fun. So, Danielle, I bought these, and it says extreme sour. And then I also found these as well, which I'm scared about, toxic waste. So they're all not open, so I don't know what they taste like, and we thought it'd be a bit of fun. You guys can see me die. I thought it would be a good idea, but now that I've bought it and know that people can actually do it, it makes me like get all tight in my jaw already.
can get really sore. Oh, oh my goodness. All right, so we'll go through. Let me. Until it cools down. All right, guys. So we made our coconut milk panna cotta. So panna cotta is an Italian cold dessert, similar to like a jelly, but it's traditionally based with a heavy cream and gelatin. We did our version today. We did it with coconut milk, gelatin, some orange blossom and orange juice. And then we've made a rhubarb and orange blossom compote or a sauce. And then we are going to top that later on. We need to make sure that the compote's cold next time. Good one, Molly. And then this is one of my favorite foods to make and eat. This is a chicken and mushroom risotto. So we did garlic and onion in the pan. We fried them, added some mushrooms. I just used some portobello Swiss brown mushrooms, fried that, then we added the arborio rice or the risotto rice, added some white wine, some chicken stock slowly. We finished it off with some dried parsley, dried thyme and oregano. We folded through some blue cheese and parmesan, topped it off with some fresh parsley as well. Cash, Beanie and Paul have ate chilies, raw eggs, and I forgot what else when they IRL stream. Oh my gosh. Ugh, raw eggs. Ugh. That makes me feel sick. I don't want it. I'm not eating chilies on stream. Ugh. You guys have enough issues with me crying because of the onions. I don't know. I can't imagine crying because of chilies. All right. So guys, we'll go to next time. So we're not streaming tomorrow. Thursday's a non-stream day for cooking, definitely. So we may keep updated with us on our socials. Make sure you hit us up on our socials because we may do some gaming streams tomorrow. We might play some golf with friends, maybe do some Overwatch. I also have a few other games that I've been trying to play. Some Wolfenstein and things like that. So if you're interested, hit us up in the socials, do exclamation mark socials in the chat, and then you can hit us up there. Friday is our Miss Molly Makes Around the World, where we do themed cuisine. We're doing Argentinian food. So Argentina is very, very famous for their meat. So we're doing some grilled skirt steak, some nice grilled steak, and then we're serving it with a chimichurri, which is a herb-based sauce. Really yummy, really nice acid, fresh herbs, it's really delicious. We're making some empanadas, which is similar to a pasty or pasty, whatever you want to call them. Meat in some pastry and then baked in the oven, really, really good. And then finishing off with a creme caramel, which is similar to the panna cotta. It's just a dessert using condensed milk made into like a jelly and then it's baked, and you also got a beautiful caramel sauce. So it's gonna be really delicious, really fun night. So 7:30 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time, the same starting time as tonight. And then this weekend, we also have our Star Wars theme show, and we also have some fun things coming up. We are getting our sub button, which is very exciting this week. So hit us up in our socials. We are interested in you guys giving us idea what you want for emotes. We have three tiers of emotes, so the $4.99, $9.99 and $24.99. And keep updated, keep following us here and check regularly below when we announce the subs. You'll see what we're going to be giving away for our subs. Just our appreciation for you guys supporting us. We want to give you a little something and some fun things that's going to be happening in the future. So now we've started our Molly dollars. You guys can start accruing from today and then also save them up, and then we'll do some redemptions hopefully in the next stream or whatnot.
And we'll be giving, doing some different things in the future during the stream, so that gives you a chance to earn some extra dollars, okay? All right, so we will see you Friday, 7:30 p.m. But also keep updated, because we might do an ad hoc stream, gaming stream tomorrow night. So it's lovely to see you all. I'm gonna eat this delicious food and take some photos for you all. Hope you have a lovely night, and so lovely to see you all. Bye.